Jesus would do miracles for folk and then tell it not to tell nobody. Amen. Jesus would do miracles for people and say, don't tell nobody. Amen. And would hold them to be quiet. Go to Matthew chapter 8 and verse 4. Right? I'm not going to hold you very long. And in Matthew chapter 8 and verse 4, look at this. We're going to go through a few examples. In Matthew chapter 8, around verse 4, amen. The Bible says, this is after Jesus healed a man from leprosy. The Bible says that Jesus said unto him, see that thou tell no man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer the gift that Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. So here he's telling, don't tell nobody. Amen. Go to Matthew chapter 9 and verse 30. Matthew chapter 9 and verse 30. Amen. We see here, amen, and this after the Lord healed a man by touching his eyes. He opened a blind man's eyes. And verse 30 says, amen. Hallelujah. Verse 29 says, then touched he their eyes, saying, according to your faith be it unto you. And her eyes were opened, and Jesus straightly charged them, saying, see that no man what? Know it. Huh? Huh? Amen. Praise the Lord. So he straightly charged. That straightly charged means he gave him a stiff warning. Amen. Don't tell nobody. Go to Matthew chapter 12 and verse 16. Matthew 12 and verse 16. And the Bible says, start at verse 15. The Bible says, and when Jesus knew it, he withdrew himself from thence, and great multitudes followed him, and healed them all, and charged them that they should not make him what? No. So here, Jesus is coming, and Jesus did a great healing. He healed a withered man's hand on the Sabbath day. And then after he healed the withered man's hand on the Sabbath day, folks started following him. And when the multitude started following, he started healing all kinds of people. And then after he healed all these people, he then tells them, amen, hallelujah, he charges them, in verse 16, it says, them that they should not make him known. Huh? Amen, praise the Lord. And then, amen, we see over in Mark chapter 3 and verse 12, it's another instance where the spirit cries out, a demon case cries out. Oh, glory, hallelujah. A demon case cries out in Mark chapter 3 and verse 12. And the Bible says that he straightly charged them that they should not make him known. Amen, praise the Lord. And so, amen, hallelujah. And so he began to heal all these people. And you can go in Mark chapter 5 and 43. That's when Jesus healed a damsel that had passed away. She was maybe about 12 years old. And she died, and Jesus raised her actually from the dead. And he's charged them not to say anything. And in Mark chapter 8, now 22 and 26, he tells a blind man, amen, that says, I see trees as men and everything else. But he heals him, he said, don't you say nothing. And then a little bit further, in 27 and 30, Jesus asked, who do men say that I am? And after he gave the revelation of that, he then tells him, don't tell anybody. Glory, hallelujah, Jesus' name. And so we see here through the scriptures, amen, that there are many cases where Jesus would literally tell people after he would do miracles, do not say anything. And it is something, amen, praise the Lord, because this puzzled me when I was, amen, a young man in the Lord, because, amen, when I was a student in the scriptures, I didn't understand. I said, why would you not want to tell somebody of what you've done? Amen. And there's a lot of different cases, and I don't have time to go through all of them. Maybe we'll do it in Bible study. We'll do it in Bible study. I can cover this better in Bible study. But there were different reasons for different positions. For instance, the man that had leprosy that we read about, amen, in Matthew chapter 8, around verse 4, whom Jesus had cleansed from the leprosy, amen, he was told by Jesus to go show himself to the priest. And this was because through the Levitical law, amen, in Leviticus chapter 14 and 10, whereby, amen, if you were cleansed of leprosy, you had to be declared clean. Even though you were clean, you had to be declared clean by the priest. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you at that time couldn't say that I'm all right. Glory to God. Yeah, we live in a church day to day where people say, amen, praise the Lord, and I'm all right all by myself. I don't need nobody else. I don't need church. I don't need this. I don't need that. And that's, I'm just going to worship God all by myself. And I don't need no preacher. I don't need nothing or nobody. Yeah, you do need a preacher. You need somebody to declare that you're clean. Glory, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Amen, praise the Lord. So as we see through the scriptures, amen, we see that these different things, amen, that go on. The Lord gave me a title for this. I was sitting at the table last night. The Lord gave me a title for the message. It says, tell everybody nothing. Tell everybody nothing. Glory, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. I know that's a little bit different than what, amen, we used to hear in sermons about go tell somebody. Amen, praise the Lord. But there are times when, glory, hallelujah, you have to keep your mouth shut about the great things of God. There are times when God will do some things inside of you that are so powerful and so wonderful that when you talk about them, you, amen, it's almost like a bucket that's leaking. Amen, praise the Lord. Glory, hallelujah. You know, sometimes when you have a glass with, and we've used grape juice this morning as an example, with grape juice in it, if it sits in the glass long enough, the glass will become purple like the grape juice. You understand what I'm talking about? The glass will literally become purple like the grape juice. Amen. You got folk like my children, they don't like washing dishes, so they'll put a glass up there. Hey, a little glory, hallelujah. And that glass will sit there for a while. Amen. And I come in and say, what is this glass? Why is this hair in this liquid? Because, amen, the grape juice, amen, began to turn. So when we pour out the grape juice, you find out that the bottom of the glass is purple. But sometimes what God wants you to do is when he's done things in your spirit and done some things in your heart, sometimes you need to bottle it up and keep it quiet a little bit. To allow, glory, hallelujah, the anointing of what God has done inside of you to wear on you a little bit. Glory, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes we want to tell people too quick that we've been shut in for 3 months. We want to tell people too quick, amen. This is what God told me, and God said this, and God says that. But there's a time when you need to bottle that thing up on the inside. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And just muse over that thing in a little bit. When Jesus came, amen, and Mary came to Jesus, and she ordered Jesus to go help them find some wine for the wedding feast. Glory, hallelujah. And Jesus looked at her and said, woman, what am I to do with thee? Oh, Jesus sounded a little harsh talking to his mother. Amen, praise God. But she didn't get mad with him. She sat there and mused over it for a little bit. And I believe what she had to contemplate was the fact that this is not Jesus, my boy. This is Jesus, my God. And you can't come to the conclusion of the greatness of who God is unless you bottle it up sometimes. Oh, glory, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Almost like a soda that you bottle up sometime. You know, amen. And sometimes you shake it up a little bit and get a little fizz at the top. Amen, oh, glory, hallelujah. You want to make sure that the soda got some fizz in it. You ever had a Coke that you just want to drink, but you didn't feel like drinking it right then? And you sat it up and sat it up and sat it up. Amen. I'm talking about the one that comes in the 2-liter bottles and the plastic bottles. And you know, after a time, it'll lose its fizz. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. But sometimes you got to get the soda and you got to shake it up a little bit to see if it's got some fizz left in it. To let me know if the soda is still good. And this is what we've got to do sometime. We've got to allow the voice of God, amen, to come and sit inside of our bellies. Oh, glory. And permeate on the inside a little bit. Oh, glory, hallelujah. There's some things that you can't tell everybody. Oh, glory, hallelujah. There's some great things that you can't tell everybody. But today God wants to make us better so we can go further in Jesus' name. Oh, glory, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. So we see here, amen, praise the Lord. But the Lord wanted to do this, amen, praise the Lord, he wanted to do this. But God began wanted to do a miracle, and he wanted some questions to be asked. Now, let me tell you something. When God begins to do something great in your life, especially your great revelation, salvation is yours and for your ears only. And this is where we make mistakes. Again, as I said earlier, we tell folks so soon that the revelation does not have a chance to sit on us and change us. This is why, amen, praise the Lord, when the Lord began to talk to his disciples and he began to ask them, who do men say that I am? And he began to ask them that, amen, praise the Lord, in Matthew chapter 16, amen. But he asked them, who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And then after he gave them the revelation of it, he told them, don't tell anybody, because I believe that revelation had to sit there inside their crawl. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And to let you know that some of them didn't let it sit there long enough, there were some people, amen, like Thomas, who forgot, glory, hallelujah, that who he was, so that when he died and rose from the dead again, he didn't realize or learn the revelation that God wanted him to have from the beginning, that he was God inside the flesh. This is why some of the apostles got up and got scatterbrained after Jesus died, because they didn't allow the revelation of who he is to sit inside of him. And I'm here to tell you right now, saints, as apostolic people baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost, God wants to do some things inside of us, but we've got to allow God to work on the inside and begin to muse over things on the inside so that God can change us on the outside. It's not so much of what you say when you open your mouth with the life you live, when you get up to show how great God is in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah, is what God has called for and what God wants to do in Jesus' name. It is this revelation of God that has moved man and moved people from place to place. Oh, glory, hallelujah, amen. Over in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, amen, I'm sorry, chapter 12, we see in the scriptures, amen, hallelujah, where actually Paul got a revelation from God. Over in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, he talks about, amen, the time when God took him to the third heaven and he heard things that was unspeakable. Oh, glory, hallelujah. You understand what I'm talking about? The heavier things that God showed you, can't tell nobody. Amen. They were unspeakable. And therefore, amen, the Bible says, and I talked about this sometime before, that he was so afraid to leak it out that he said, I knew a man. And then he said, whether in the body or out of the body, I cannot tell. Whether in the body or out of the body, I cannot tell. Amen. And he said, verse 4, chapter 12, verse 4, how that he was caught up into paradise and heard unspeakable words, which it is not lawful for a man to utter. Let me tell you something. There are things that God wants to tap in you to tap into that's not lawful for you to speak in this dispensation and in this time. Amen, praise the Lord. And there's some things, amen, because if you speak it in this dispensation and time, it'll start things to go in certain areas before God wants it to go in that area. The revelation that God wants to do and show you that is so, glory, hallelujah, powerful, until God knows that you've not gotten there yet to show forth the greatness of God, but he wants you to keep it in your heart so that it can change you on the inside and may get you up to the level that God wants you to go in Jesus' name. That's why Paul began to say, amen, praise the Lord. In verse 6, then he says, for though I would desire to glory, I should not be a fool, for I will say the truth, that now I forbear, lest any man should think of me above that which he seeth me to be, or that he heareth of me. He says, at least I should be exalted above what? Measure through the abundance of the revelations. You see, too many times, God will give us revelation, and the revelation that we like to speak out and tell people, amen, praise the Lord, get us raised to a level in ourselves so that we get to a point where I can't hear a preacher no more because I got a revelation. And I know some people say, well, you're trying to tell me that God didn't speak to me? No, I'm not telling you he didn't speak to you. I'm telling you, you didn't hold on to what he spoke to you correctly. Because if you held on to it and kept it in your spirit, in your heart, you'll still be subject. So you can get further understanding in Jesus' name. As a matter of fact, the Bible began to say, amen, praise the Lord. He says, through the abundance of the revelation that there was given to me, a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffet me. In other words, he was saying Satan was sent specifically to do nothing but to beat me and buffet me, not so that he can take the revelation from me, but so that he can seal the revelation inside of me. Oh, glory, hallelujah. You understand this? The devil, amen, belongs to God too. Oh, glory, hallelujah. He's sovereign. And meaning he's sovereign means God has the ability to make the devil do just what he wants when he wants him to do it. You understand what we're talking about? So God will literally send the devil to buffet, glory, hallelujah, Paul, to seal the revelation in him, to seal it, and beat him, and just to beat him. And when Paul, amen, was getting the beating, I can see Paul go, ow, oh, ow, ow. He said, God, why you letting the devil do this to me? Why you letting him do this to me? Glory, hallelujah, God is saying, I'm trying to seal revelation inside you, so that you can go further in me in Jesus' name. So finally, after Paul had gotten whipped by Satan, oh, glory, you don't like whippings, you don't like going through anything, but finally, after Paul got beaten by Satan, the Bible says, amen, hallelujah, that he asked the Lord, and besought him thrice, oh, glory, hallelujah, he said, Lord, why let this thing depart from me? Let the devil leave me alone. But the Lord did not even mention what Satan was doing to him. All the Lord told Paul is, in verse 9, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. In other words, amen, God was telling Paul, every time you get beat to the point where you're so weak that you don't know whether you're going or coming, when my strength is perfected in you. Let me tell you something, saints of God. That is a revelation from on high. Because we're at a people, we're a group of folk that think that we're supposed to be blessed all the time. We're supposed to be healed all the time. We think that we're not supposed to go through anything. And when we go through something, we look at the Lord like something strange is happening. But let me tell you something, that sometimes God wants to put you through things so we can seal his revelation inside of you. And so that when the revelation gets sealed inside of you, after you come over and through what the devil is placing on you, you can be perfected and go further in the name of Jesus. As a matter of fact, the Bible says in verse 10, he says, therefore I take pleasure in infirmities. Well, how do you take pleasure in going through? How do you take pleasure, glory, hallelujah, in being punished? How do you take pleasure in being sick? How can you take pleasure in being broke? How do you take oh, glory, I'm talking to myself today. Oh, glory, you need a revelation to take pleasure in that. I understand what faith is, and I believe God will bless me, and I believe I am blessed. But sometimes in my blessedness, I got to be broke so I can receive the revelation from God. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Because I can't get the revelation when things are going too well. There's a brokenness that I got to go through so I can get the revelation of being blessed in Jesus' name. If I were never broke, I wouldn't shout giving the glory when he blessed me with money. If I were never sick, I'd never give the glory when he heals me. Oh, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. If everything was perfect in my relationships, I'd not know how to give him the glory. When folk learn to understand me, when they misunderstood me, you got to go through in Jesus' name and learn to shut up and be blessed in Jesus' name. Oh, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, boy, you got to learn how to tell everybody nothing. You got to learn how to tell everybody nothing. You got to learn, amen, that when you're going through, amen, sometimes God don't want you to have a shoulder to cry on. Oh, glory. glory. I know this is stunning to some, but sometimes God don't want you to have a shoulder to cry on. Sometimes He don't want you to have somebody to show you that they love you. Oh glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. Sometimes He'll let the people that misunderstand you the most be the people you live with. Be the people that sleep in your bed next to you. The folk that you feed. Oh glory, hallelujah. How you supposed to know you blessed if you don't go through the valley sometimes? If you don't go through misunderstanding sometimes? How do you know, amen, hallelujah? You got to understand and you got to step there. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Your boss calling out your name. They saying you're a thief. They saying you're slapped and everything else. But you know that that ain't true. Because you've been doing everything that you're supposed to do. Oh, glory, hallelujah. You got to sit there and take it in the name of Jesus. Sometime in church, you can be called everything but a child of God. I've been there. Oh, Lord, when people preached on me and talked about me and everything else, and everything they said wasn't true. But God didn't allow me to jump up and throw a temper tantrum and grab my Bible and walk out. But I had to sit there on the front row. Oh, Lord, hallelujah, Lord. I had to sit on the front row so I can take everything the devil had to throw at me. And let me tell you something. I went through a time when I figured if I slipped to the second row and then slipped to the third row, and I was going to move back slow. You know what I'm talking about. I was going to kind of slip. I was going to move back slow. So, amen, when people got used to not seeing me in the front row, I can get up and slip out the back. But the Lord knew exactly what I had in mind. And He said, get your little old praise here right back on the front row. Because you got to go through this in Jesus' name. He's still anointing in me. He's still appointing in me. He's still wisdom in me. He's still it all inside me. Because I had to go through and not say nothing in Jesus' name. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Oh, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You got to understand, amen, that the revelation that God will impart on you, oh, glory, hallelujah, it is not for you to speak. It is not for you to say anything. As a matter of fact, amen, and this is the issue that a lot of us have, because we want to just tell people everything. Amen. Like my dad used to say, we got diarrhea of the mouth. When God does something inside of us, we just want to let it run all over the place. You want to tell people, oh, look what God did. And God did this in my prayer last night. And God did that in my prayer last night. And we just want to just tell folk everything. But let me tell you, honey, most times God wants you to shut up and hold it in. Glory, hallelujah. And say, amen, hallelujah. I feel like I'm going to bust if I don't get it out. Oh, glory, hallelujah. But understand, when you feel like you're going to bust, and when God is shaking up the bottle, so the anointing can get, oh, glory, it's not fizzing in Jesus' name. When you say, I got to tell somebody about what God has done to me. But amen, God said, no, 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 you hush up. Oh, glory, He did it to the prophet Jeremiah when he said, it feels like fire shut up inside my bones, anointing and things that God wants to do. What God wants me to say to the people, God will put the word inside and He'll shake the bottle and shake it. So you get to a point, amen, where you say, Lord, if I don't do this, I'll tell people what you've done to for me. I'm going to bust in Jesus' name. But the Lord said, you're not ready yet to allow, amen, all what I placed in you to come out. Because if you allow it to come out, you will not have changed the way I'm calling you to change. In Jesus' name, saints, we got to realize that God wants to do something great inside us. And God has called us to holiness, not on the outside, but on the inside first, so that we can show up the power and the anointing in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. You don't know how people have come by. False prophets and everybody else that want to say that I tell your heart. Oh, Lord, I had a prophet come by here one time and got mad with me because I told him, amen, hallelujah, that the scriptures don't allow women pastors. And he got so mad with me until he told me, he said, everything you got is going to fall apart. And I said, that's all right, I don't own it anyway. It belongs to God. And he said, if you don't hush, he said, I tell what's in your heart. I opened up my jacket, I better tell it. I said, oh, I've got to put something inside. Tell it.